So I've edited somewhere around 50,000 photos in the last decade for clients, for myself, for YouTube, for prints, for fun, and even for big companies. And in this video, I want to share with you the lessons that actually matter and make you better. I'm talking about this kind of stuff that like no one tells you. So let's break it down into 7 simple tips that once you like fully understand will make you like 10 times better at editing photos instantly. All right, tip number 1. You see, everyone wants to like find their style. So they download like 10 presets, slap them on a few photos, and then they hope that it just magically feels right. But here's the thing that I've come to understand. Your style, it isn't something that you just find. It's something that you build. And it comes from doing the reps, editing a ton of photos over and over and over again. I'm talking things like tweaking a little bit, trying, failing, reworking even, until you start to trust your own eyes and instinct. You can kind of think of it like handwriting. You didn't choose how you write. It's something that you developed by writing every single day. But the cool thing is that a handwriting, it can be perfected. I mean, mine looks like absolutely dog shit. But I know that if I were to put my mind into it, I'm sure that it would look like some English lord from the 1800s. You understand? I would be like, oh, my lady, here is my handwriting. By the way, I made a free 30-day email series, 1 short email a day packed with 1 useful editing tip that will massively level up your editing skills. Or if it does not do that, you, my friend, will get your monies back. Well, it's kind of free and you can find the like link in the description down below. I hope that the handwriting and analogy made a little bit sense. I know that nobody writes anymore with hands, but I think you like get what I'm trying to say. Anywho, the point I was trying to make with it is that your editing style works the same way. The more you edit, the more your instinct will sharpen, like a sharp knife. Basically, you start to notice the patterns and what it is that you like. And those patterns, my friend, they will become your style. Make sense? So stop chasing presets and using them like they were some sort of magic pills. I mean, presets, they're awesome and I do use them a lot. But in my opinion, you should use them as like a starting point. But know this, your style, it will come from repetition. It comes from the time you sit in this chair and are editing your photos again and again and again and actually doing the work. And once it starts to click for you, editing just feels effortless. However, with all that being said, then none of that actually matters if you're just dragging the sliders in Lightroom without knowing what they do. Because the next shift is what honestly took my editing from just random things to repeatable. So that brings us to tip number 2. If there's like one thing I wish somebody had told me early on, it's this. Editing is not about fixing, it's about shaping. So in my opinion, most people, they open up Lightroom, they maybe slap on a preset, they start moving a few sliders, and then they just hope that it looks good. That's kind of like building a house without having a blueprint. So before you touch anything, ask yourself, what is it that I want this specific photo to feel like? What is the story here? I know this is like very theoretic, but I'm trying to get you guys to understand how I think about editing photos. And in my opinion, editing, it's like visual storytelling. Basically, the point that I'm trying to drive home here is that if the photo is meant to feel warm and nostalgic, you're going to approach it extremely differently than if it's meant to be like cold and dramatic or clean and modern. And once you have the intent, every slider becomes like a tool, not just a guess. It's kind of like you're cooking. You just don't go down to the kitchen and throw in a bunch of ingredients in the pan and then you hope for the best. Then like your missus won't be happy. You basically first decide what dish you're gonna make and then every decision supports that vision, all right? Editing, in my opinion, it kind of works the same way. Intent first, sliders second. So you might be sitting there now, watching a handsome ginger guy talking and being like, okay, Mr. Icelandic guy, that sounds awesome. Your metaphors on point, my friend. But what does that look like in practice? Well, let's say that I'm editing a photo and I decide, okay, this right here is the subject and I want the mood to feel soft and cinematic. Then if I've decided that, I have a direction. And in my opinion, that was the biggest shift for me and the biggest shift I want you to have too. And once that clicks, editing, it stops being something that is like, oh, what am I doing? What is happening? It's so intimidating, and starts becoming fun. Anywho, now that you've got a vision, you're editing with purpose. But there is this one thing that separates beginners from like the pros. And it's not the gear, it's not the preset, or even like your camera. It is this. Tip number three. When I like look back at my old edits, everything was kind of turned up to 11. Basically, clarity, absolutely cracked. Contrast, maxed out. Colors, kind of radioactive. It was kind of like I was trying to make the photos shout at people. And in my opinion, it's just pretty embarrassing. But I think it's often like this when you're starting out. However, over time and after tens of thousands of images, I have realized something. Epiphany has struck that Icelandic guy. Basically, great edits, they don't scream, they whisper, kind of. I'm being a little, you know, poetic here, but bear with me, my friend. In my opinion, great edits, they guide the viewer's eyes without hitting them in the head. Woo! Poetic. I should just start a poetic channel here, a poetry channel. Not pottery channel, a poetry channel. That Icelandic poetry guy. Anyway, enough of the silliness. Basically, you can think of editing like seasoning. Too little and your photo, it feels bland. And too much and it can ruin like the entire dish. Anyway, these days my edits are much more minimal. Full disclosure though, I do love editing and I often get like completely carried away. I know that. But I aim for much smaller, more intentional tweaks. That's my aim, you know? And what does that mean? Basically, a little warmth in the highlights, maybe slight tone adjustments. I'm using a bunch of soft masks everywhere with the intention to try to pull my viewers' eyes towards the subject. So basically, I'm trying to say that you don't need to prove anything in your edits. You just need to support the photo and not overpower it. And when you get that balance right, it just feels, you know, it feels good. However, keep this in mind throughout everything when it comes to photography and editing is that editing is an art and art, it is subjective. The best thing you can do is to edit the way that just feels and looks right to you and is true to your vision and what you see in your head. I think the best thing that you can do is to learn to trust your own instincts. That being said though, over-editing, it's not just a myth, it's definitely a real thing. And the sooner that you develop that internal, this feels maybe like a bit too much. You know that radar that we all have in ourselves we don't often listen to? That, my friend, is when your work gets a lot better. By the way, if this way of thinking about editing makes sense to you, then you'd probably or most likely love my Lightroom Masterclass. It's everything that I've learned over editing over 50,000 photos and it's packed into one simple step-by-step course that actually shows you how to think and what to do inside of Lightroom Classic. And you know, I want this to be a complete thing. So now we go way beyond just slider explanations, although I show you, of course, all of that too. But I walk you through real edits, break down my process and help you build your style and edit with confidence and actually understand Lightroom on a much like deeper level. So if you ever felt like editing is overwhelming or like your photos never quite match your vision, then this course is made for you, my friend. At the time of the recording, I think over 100 photographers, if I remember correctly, have taken it. And I can guarantee you that your editing skills will dramatically improve in just 30 days or you will get your money back. Anyway, there's a link down in the description if you want to check it out. Now, we talked about intention and being subtle. Both of them are key ingredients when it comes to great edits. But none of that will save your photo if, my friend, the raw material isn't there. Basically, what I'm trying to say is that at the end of the day, Lightroom, it can do a lot, but it can't perform miracles. And that, my friend, is why we need to dive together, hand in hand, into tip number four. All right, so this one, it might sting a little bit, but it is very much true. You see, if the light moment or the composition isn't there, no amount of Lightroom magic will turn this image into like a masterpiece. And my friend, I say this as someone who's like tried many, many, many times. I've spent hours trying to rescue photos that were just like, man, not that good. I'm talking photos where the colors were just flat, the moment was kind of boring, and the subject wasn't even clear, and composition was just way off. And the thing is, of course, you can polish it, you can throw some vibe on it, but it's still at the end of the day, just a meh photo put in a nice suit. I live in Sweden, and here in Sweden they have a saying which is like, putting makeup on a pig. That's basically what this is. Anyway, let's go back to our food metaphors. And I am a little bit hungry, and I think that shows a lot. I've been doing a little bit of shredding, trying to take away this dad body that I built now that I've had a few kids. And I think every metaphor is going to be food today. Anyway, you can think of editing like seasoning a dish and not cooking a whole meal. If the ingredients are bad, no amount of salt or butter will make it all of a sudden taste amazing. And what does that mean for us photographers and photo editors? Basically, if you're spending way too much time trying to fix the shot, it might be worth stepping back and asking, is this photo actually worth saving? And instead, focus on getting things right in camera. And that means when you're out shooting, watch for the light, pay attention to the composition, and anticipate the moment. Be like a ninja with your camera. You understand what I'm trying to say here. Simply put, when the raw image is strong, editing it becomes fun because you're not fixing anything, you're elevating and taking it to new heights and creating a masterpiece, man. In my opinion, both photography and editing matters like a lot. And when they're both strong, that's where the real magic happens, which, my friend, leads us to tip number 5. You see, early on in my career, I used to obsess over skin tones, perfect sharpness, perfect histograms, and all that stuff. But the truth is, most of your favorite photos, they aren't perfect, they just feel real. You understand what I'm saying? And that can mean that they're like heavily edited, but they have some sort of feeling to them. Kind of like acting. You see, you can have like the most technically perfect performance, but if that performance doesn't feel authentic to the audience, it just falls flat, right? The best actors, in my opinion, they make you forget that they were acting at all. For example, Jennifer Lawrence in Hunger Games, I swear to God, she is Katniss pretending to be Jennifer Lawrence playing herself. You understand? And the point that I'm trying to make here is that the same goes for editing. A great edit, it shouldn't draw attention to itself, it should draw attention to the photo. You understand? You're not seeing it and be like, oh, that's a lot of editing. You're just saying like, wow, that's a super cool photo. Instead of asking, is this photo technically perfect? Try asking yourself these questions. 1, does this feel believable? 2, does this feel good? 3, would I stop and look at this photo if I were to see it in the wild? Now, if you want to do a super quick test, and one of the best things that I've learned in photo editing is that step away from the screen for just 30 seconds or even 30 minutes, then you can come back and look at it with a fresh pair of eyes. If something jumps out when you do that, you probably need to dial things back. And it's so easy to get carried away in your own photo editing and be like, wow, this looks awesome. I just drag this a little bit more. And then you don't see that you've gone like way too far, but just 30 seconds or a little break, coming back with a fresh pair of eyes, and you'd be like, whoa, why did I do that? So that's a very good tip. And like, ironically, when you stop trying to make your edits absolutely perfect, they actually kind of start looking a whole lot better. I don't know how, but it's just something when you're not trying, when things just fall in place and happen. Now, up until this point, we've mostly been talking about mindset, but here's where the tools actually start to matter. Because once you like move past the guessing and start to really understand what those sliders really do, editing, in my opinion, becomes so much more fun. It's like you unlock something. And that is where we dive into tip number 6. You see, as we talked about in the beginning of this video, many people, when they open up Lightroom, they just start by sliding a few sliders around. More contrast, less exposure, maybe push the blues a little bit, or maybe pull down the oranges. It's basically just all trial and error. And hey, that works for a while, you know? But if you want consistency and confidence in your edits, you need to move beyond just guessing. Let's do another metaphor. So think about this as sculpting. At first, you're just hacking away at a block of marble. I think I've never sculpted anything, but that's how I think it is. And you're hoping that it looks like something. But once you understand how the tool that you're using works, you can start shaping with intention. All right? That's basically, in my opinion, in Lightroom, what calibration, curves, and masking allow you to do. Many beginners feel that those are pretty intimidating, but these are the tools, my friend, that let you, one, control the colors from the ground up, two, target like specific tones without affecting the rest of the entire image, and then three, sculpting light and contrast exactly the way that you want it and see it, all right? And as I said, I know these tools can be a little bit intimidating at first. Sure, know there, been there. But once you like understand them, they give you full control over your image. And this, my friend, is a big turning point for a lot of editors. And a lot of people that have coached and helped out with photo editing, once they understand this, it's kind of like this aha moment. So if you want to level up fast, stop thinking about Lightroom just as a bunch of sliders and start thinking about it as a tool for like sculpturing light and color. You understand? We're creating masterpieces. We're artists, you know? Or at least that's what I say to my mother. I'm an artist. I do art. Now, this next one, it might feel a little bit uncomfortable, but that is actually a good sign. Because if you are cringing at your old edits, that means that you're like growing, which leads us to tip number 7. Now, there was a time when I thought teal and orange, it was like the pinnacle of editing. Everything had to be contrasty and dramatic and color graded to the gills, you know? And the thing is, at the time, I absolutely loved it. I mean, I still like heavy edits and I know that I edit my photos a ton. But the funny thing about like becoming better is fast forward a couple of years and I look back at those edits and I go just,
what the hell was I thinking, you know?
And that's to everything. Even my YouTube videos, I don't want to, I just cringe when I see that. But here is the thing. What I'm looking at when I'm looking back at my old edits or old videos or whatever, it's not failures. It's progress. Your taste in things, it's supposed to change. By looking back at your old things, you're supposed to be like, what was I thinking of? This is so bad and cringy and embarrassing. I should like delete this. Feeling like this is one of the clearest signs that we are improving. When your old work starts to make you winch a little bit, it means that you're like seeing more. You're expanded your brain and you're noticing subtleties. Is that an English word? You know, you're noticing that the small little things that you like missed before. You brain expanded yourself. You know, we're biohackers. You know them YouTubers. Bro, you want to biohack yourself? Basically, what I'm trying to say is that you now holding yourself to higher standards, and that's a good thing. And every time your taste like evolves, your editing, it will evolve with it. And my friend, that's, in my opinion, how you develop your style. The thing that I'm trying to drive home and say here is that it doesn't happen all at once or overnight. We live in a day and age where everything should happen so fast and instant gratification and all that, you know? It happens by constantly leveling up how you see, constantly doing it, constantly putting in the reps, and constantly becoming and trying to become a better photographer and a photo editor. Now, if you're just getting into Lightroom, or even if you've been using it for a while, but still feel like you're kind of winging it, then my friend, you need to watch this video here next.